Good afternoon, and welcome here to our Blue Christmas service in Biggar Kirk. I think you all know me, but my name's Mike Fuchella, if you don't. Next Tuesday will be the shortest day of the year, and along with the shortest day comes the longest night. If you were to glance at your shadow on or around noon on Tuesday, it would be the longest shadow that you will see all year. We're in the midst of a season of great joy and light, but for many of us, it feels more like a season of great darkness and long shadows. The festivities going on around us bring a great contrast to our own situation. Loneliness, grief, loss, separation, pain, sickness, anxiety. This afternoon we gather to acknowledge the contrast that we feel inside. This afternoon we gather maybe wondering if God really has come in Jesus that we celebrate at this Christmas time. This afternoon we gather with some who we know and others who we don't know. Yet we are brought together as a family in our grief and in our brokenness. This afternoon I'd invite you to be honest and vulnerable, for God has promised to meet us here, and he welcomes us just as we are. I'm going to play a well-known Christmas carol as some reflective music. Let's just sit and listen and be quiet. Thank you. O come, Emmanuel. Let's approach God in prayer. Let's pray together. Lord God, we come before you this afternoon, acknowledging that we are fragile people, acknowledging that we fail and fumble and we are often hurt by circumstances or by our own decisions and actions. But thank you, Lord, that from of old, when your people were in dire straits, you never left them there. But in your good time, you always came to the rescue. And in the Christmas story that we celebrate at this season, you showed in the most glorious way your heart of empathy and love for us. When the scriptures say the time was right, you sent your Son into the world, not to condemn the world, but to save it. Lord, we acknowledge that we too are part of that world, and we do need your saving. Help us not to leave the baby Jesus asleep in the hay, in that idyllic scene we have created over years of remembering this story. But help us to remember rightly. This was a story that happened in the midst of pain and fear and loss. Help us also to remember that this Jesus would grow in wisdom and stature. He was one who would show his compassion by healing the sick, giving direction to the wayward, and comforting and giving hope to the sorrowful. And so we ask you, Lord Jesus, to come and heal, teach, and comfort us. We remember also his passion, that when at the last through wood and nails, Jesus Christ, by his own suffering, bought for us ultimate release from all suffering and pain. Come, Lord Jesus, give us hope that because of your death upon the cross and your resurrection, that the victory of the way of love is assured, and your kingdom will not falter, but will in the end prevail. Come now, Spirit of Christ, wounded healer, inspire our meditations in this hour, for we pray in your name. Amen. Do you know mistletoe? We don't see it very often these days. It's quite a rare plant. But it's hung in doorways this time of year, and it is traditional to give one another a kiss under the mistletoe. It's supposed to bring good luck. And here's one fact that I don't think you know about mistletoe. It was the state flower of Oklahoma until a few years ago. When it was first proposed that it should be the state flower, there was an outcry. For you see, mistletoe is a semi-parasitic plant. It grows high up in the branches of other trees, and it lives off their moisture and their minerals, as well as producing its own nutrients through photosynthesis. Now, Okies, those people who live in Oklahoma, like most Americans and like us here in Scotland, are fiercely independent. So when it was proposed that their state flower should be a parasitic plant, a plant that lives off another plant, many people objected. But you know, being dependent on something else, whether it's plants for food or another person for comfort and support, is not a bad thing at all. Indeed, it is how things usually work. Sometimes it's a lesson that comes hard to us, to be dependent. If you're sitting here this afternoon, then I'm guessing that you have learned a thing or two about your ability to handle things on your own. Some days, some weeks, some years. However, life just knocks us down, and we realize how vulnerable we really are. When a spouse, a child, or a parent dies, and when the doctor says cancer, when the boss says you're redundant, when things break down irreparably in relationships that we thought would last a lifetime, when the reporter on the news says 26 dead, 20 of them children, when we're brought to the uncomfortable realization that we lack the strength to go it alone. These loads are too heavy. This pain is too intense. This darkness that we feel will not be vanquished by our strength and our fortitude, or even a positive attitude. And so we gather here this afternoon on the edge of one of the longest nights of the year. We gather to acknowledge that we cannot go it alone. We need a light in the darkness. We need hope for tomorrow. We need a friend. We've been uprooted in one way or another, and we need some place to call home. Sisters and brothers, this afternoon, we come seeking the tree of life, Jesus Christ. We know now more than ever that we cannot live without him. We, like the humble mistletoe plant, need to be grafted into that tree in order to survive. We need his love. We need his grace, his forgiveness. We need his hope. We need the promise that this darkness is not all there is. We need the hope that one day we will have the strength to bloom once again. We need to know that we are not alone in this world. Behind all the tinsel and the bustle of this season, this is the heart of the message of Christmas. That God knows our need for him, that he has come to be with us, not just as a baby in a manger a long time ago, but God comes by his Spirit today to comfort us, to heal us, to redeem us. God is here with us if we open our hearts to him. So listen to God's words in Scripture. Listen to them as God's words for you right now. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. Like a shepherd tends his flock, he gathers up the lambs with his arm. He carries them close to his heart. I have made you, and I will bear you. I will carry and save you. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Let us pray. Lord God, come to us. Your servants wait. We wait for you to come in your good time, in your quiet yet powerful ways. Come in the still small voice in the tiny baby of Bethlehem, and in your brokenness upon the cross. Come, Lord Jesus. Lord God, some of us here today have lost those whom we loved. And it feels as if we have a big hole in our hearts. We don't ask you to fill that hole, because we do not want to forget the joy we had and have lost. But we do ask you to speak your healing words. We want you to touch our hearts so that our remembering will be a joy, full of hope that one day all that is lost will be found and restored in your kingdom of love. And Lord God, some of us come with heartaches of other kinds today. Perhaps we feel trapped by something or someone. Perhaps we feel we have failed someone or something. Perhaps we are sad because someone we love is ill or hurting in another way. Lord God, we know we cannot undo the past. And sometimes it is hard to see how the present can be any different than it is. And Lord, we confess that we find it hard to believe or to hope. Lord, help us even in our unbelief, and give us your hope. We pray in Christ's name, because in him you have shown us not just your sympathy, but your empathy for all we are, all we feel, and all we experience. Amen. As we close this afternoon, you are invited to sit for a time in silence, acknowledging your loss, your separation, maybe your confusion. If it feels uncomfortable at first, it is our prayer today that we can begin to feel that the silence and the darkness around us are the embrace of God. A God whose spirit is hovering ever near to us. A God who is present. A God who's present maybe even more powerfully in our pain, and a God who promises that it will not be dark forever. On Wednesday, the days will begin to get longer. It will be imperceptible at first, but over time, winter will give way to spring, and spring will give way to summer. May it be the same way as God brings the light of hope into your life. We're going to sit in silence for 2 minutes. And after that time of silence, I will light the Christ candle. Usually we don't light the Christ candle until Christmas Eve, until the morning of Christmas Day. It represents Christ coming into the world. But brothers and sisters, Christ has come already. He is here. So I will light that candle. And from the Christ candle, I will light a tea light for someone I know and love and whom I am missing. And then I want to invite you to come and light your own candle. Take your time, one at a time. You may wish to name aloud your sadness to God or the person that you're thinking of. You're then invited either to return to your seat and spend some more time in silence, or you can go after that. There will be no formal ending to this afternoon. Take your time and this holy space, and when you're ready, you may leave. If you desire prayer, please just remain in your seat after the others have gone, and Jane will come and pray with you. So let's just take a few minutes in silence now.